Hello everyone. Today we are going to look at a fairly straightforward and simple case of hysteroscopic myoma resection. The patient in question is a 35-year-old lady. She has a 1 cm fibroid, submucous fibroid on the posterior wall of the uterus, which has been reported on ultrasound as a type 1 fibroid, which means that more than 60% of it is projecting inside the endometrial cavity. She has also been reported to have focal adenomyosis over the posterior wall of the uterus, which is close to the endometrial cavity. And the presenting complaints of this lady are menorrhagia and dysmenorrhea. So she is not interested in fertility, but is extremely keen on preserving the uterus for future menstruation. So let's see how the surgery proceeds. So we start the surgery. We are going into the uterine cavity. The instrument being used is a 2.9 mm telescope with a Bitocchi sheath, and the surgery is being performed under regional anesthesia, spinal anesthesia. So as we go inside, we can clearly see the fibroid over the posterior wall, the ostium on one side and the ostium on the other side. Now this fibroid has been reported to be a type 1 fibroid, so more than 50% is in the cavity, but it doesn't look like that right now when we are doing hysteroscopy. Therefore, when the intrauterine pressure is reduced, you can see that the fibroid bulges clearly into the endometrial cavity. Now the distension pressure is almost zero, and you can see that now the fibroid has bulged more than 60 to 70% inside the endometrial cavity. So the preoperative ultrasound finding is definitely now validated. Let's now take a look with the resectoscope. So we are going in with the resectoscope now, and as you can see, because we are using a 22 French instrument, some cervical dilatation is required. And now you can see how the findings inside have changed, and the fibroid looks even more invisible because a little excess intrauterine distension pressure has been used to enter and to account for the leakage that is occurring from the dilated cervix. So we are using a bipolar resectoscope, a 22 French bipolar resectoscope, and the fibroid is being shaved off in small pieces with the current being activated and the loop being pulled towards the surgeon to avoid perforation. You can see that the texture and the color of the fibroid is different from the normal intrauterine tissue. You can also note that we are trying to work at a very minimum intrauterine distension pressure, because at a high distension pressure, the fibroid, as we demonstrated earlier, will get pushed more into the myometrium and less of the fibroid will be available to the operating surgeon for performing the surgery. The chips, they do keep floating, but the attempt is made to try and push them towards the fundus as much as possible. So small pieces of the fibroid are now taken out, and now you can see that the brown color is slowly making way to a more pinkish tissue that signifies that the surgeon has now reached the normal myometrium. So in small pieces, the bits of the fibroid are taken out and the lower underlying pink myometrium is visualized. Now as the distension is reduced, blood vessels do come up, but another projection is coming up in the center, which does not seem to be a residual part of the fibroid, but a new fibroid which had probably got missed because of the on the ultrasound and not seen before. So this fibroid also needs to be taken out, because at zero distension pressure, the fibroid will bulge again into the intrauterine cavity. So I am trying to resect this fibroid, but as you can see, because of the high distension pressure, the fibroid is almost invisible to the surgeon's eye. This makes it mandatory to reduce the pressure, the distension pressure, to extremely low levels, though at the cost of a bloody field that interferes with your work, but otherwise it is impossible to take this fibroid out. So at an extremely low distension pressure, one single scoop of the resectoscope is able to detach the fibroid from its attachment to the uterus. a small strand is remaining, and this strand is cut off with the resectoscope. Although this movement of pushing with the resectoscope is certainly not recommended if the surgeon is not competent. Now, when we are reducing the intrauterine pressure, you can see that there isn't much of mass developing or projecting into the uterine cavity. Since this patient is not interested in fertility and the ultrasound is also showing some focal adenomyotic areas over the posterior surface of the uterus, we are going to try and resect a little bit more than what is required in the hope that it will relieve the patient of her pain to some extent. So we cut off small pieces of the myometrium or the adenomyotic tissue, as the case may be, and then we decrease the intrauterine pressure again to see how much is left behind. So some of these pieces can now be seen, some of the projecting over the lateral wall over here, maybe some pieces over the wall on the other side. So we are trying to dig out as much tissue as possible until we reach the normal myometrium. Here the tissue lining seems to be smooth, and we are trying to see how much is really left behind again by reducing the distension pressure. So more or less most of the pathology seems to be out, and it's time to now evacuate the pieces and take one last look at the uterine cavity before we close. All throughout the surgery, we are monitoring the inflow and the outflow very meticulously, and the outflow tubing is continuously connected to a suction apparatus so that the surgeon knows exactly how much fluid deficit we are having and when to stop the surgery. So now this is the fibroid and its pieces, which have almost been detached completely, and now let's remove the pieces and then take another look. So one last time we've gone into the uterine cavity again, and now you can see the look has changed completely because of the bleeding that has happened. The fibroid seems to be out completely. There is nothing jutting out except for this ridge, which is projecting a little bit from the posterior wall and does not seem to be in line with the rest of the myometrial outline. So I think we can assume that this is a bit of the fibroid or the adenomyotic area that has been left behind, more likely a fibroid. So we're going to go ahead and, at the risk of removing a little more tissue, we're going to try and remove this part also in the hope that it will not lead to any residual pathology in the future and the patient will get cured of her symptoms. So we are trying to remove small pieces of whatever is left behind, and again the brown color comes up signifying that it is not a normal myometrial tissue. Of course, one has to be careful about how much they excise in patients of infertility, because excising too much of tissue might result in denuding of the endometrium and might result in synechiae, which are even more difficult to treat in the long run. So we are taking out small slivers of tissue and trying to look for the normal myometrium underneath. This I think on the left side of the screen is a little bit of what is still left behind. So we're going to take that out, and we can see the normal myometrium coming up right behind it right now. So again, we reduce the distension pressure from time to time to see what is bulging and the vascularity that is left behind. And this is just again one small ridge of tissue that is left. The obvious bleeding points are then cauterized using the coagulation mode of the electrocautery. And that's more or less about it. The pathology has been removed. This is another small segment that is being taken out. And all that remains now to be done is to remove the pieces that are floating inside. Again, these pieces might just be left alone and they will get expelled in due course of time. But you do not need to really dilate the cervix too much to get these pieces out. Another way of removing the pieces effectively is to just trap the pieces between the telescope and the loop, and then remove the pieces out one by one, which then ensures that you can remove all the pieces under vision. So thank you for watching. If you like this video, please be sure to click on the icon above and subscribe to our channel for more updates.